All right. Well, welcoming to the podcast today is founder and CEO of Collectly, Levon Brutyan. Levon, how are you doing today?
How's it going, Alex? All right. Everything's perfect on my end here.
Okay, great. Well, first I'd like to ask a little bit about yourself. Can you tell me where you're from and where you grew up?
Sure, absolutely. So I was born in Moscow. Then I used to live a couple of years in Germany. Then I came back to Moscow, did my master's there, and then I moved again to Germany, lived there, worked there. And basically, then I moved to the United States in 2014 to do my MBA in San Francisco. And yeah, that's kind of, I stayed here, decided to do my startup.
Cool. That's awesome. Actually, my dad isn't currently working in Moscow, but he spent some time there. I've actually been out to visit. It's a pretty cool city.
Yeah, it is.
Did you get any tech experience there? Like, what was your experience in Moscow like?
Yeah, I used to work there for like 4-5 years, and yeah, it's it's a very big city, very New York like. A lot of good developers, software engineers, mathematicians. So a pretty nice tech community. Not, of course, not the same community you can find in San Francisco or in the Bay Area for sure. But I think that the number of people is just less who are involved in tech still, but still pretty, you know, a lot of great engineers there.
Cool. Yeah. My dad kind of had the same experience. It's kind of, in Moscow, he felt kind of like a big fish in a small pond. And moving out to San Francisco, it's like, you know, it's an ocean out here.
Yeah, that's right.
But that's, so you got some tech experience in Moscow, and that's where you kind of started your career in tech. But how long would you say you've been working in the tech business?
So in the tech business, I work more than about 10 years now, I guess. So about
okay. 10. Can you tell me a little bit about your first job in tech?
Sure. My first job in tech was basically the head of debt collection department. And then I got pretty fast a CEO position there at Credit Reform Russia. And we started to build, the tech products. And that was 2009. So, you know, like nobody knew about the lean startup yet. Right. And basically, we started to build a very complex tech product about credit reports, and it should be like an international portal where the customers all over the globe, the enterprises, they could actually get the credit reports on different companies across the globe as well. And we started to do it in with like 7 countries, and I was one of the product basically managers for this, you know, for this this portal. So that was my first kind of responsibility, and that was my first chance to build a tech product.
So it sounds like you've been doing like debt collection type stuff for a long time now. And now I'd like to get a little bit into what your business Collectly does. Can you explain a little bit about your business and
sure.
maybe how you tried to grow on top of what you'd learned previously?
Absolutely. So basically, Collectly is a data-driven patient billing platform that helps medical providers, the billing teams, especially if medical providers. Increase collections, decrease operational costs, and most importantly, elevate patient billing experience. That's the number one goal that we have, that kind of we want to achieve with our platform, to help people receive, understand, and pay their bills.
Mm-hmm. So you said elevate experience. Maybe what were some of the difficulties you saw that you want to address?
That's a great question, Alex. So I saw that, I used to work in this industry, in accounts receivables industry for many years. And I saw that all the accounts receivable departments, all the billing departments, all the debt collection companies, they treat people just like the spreadsheet rows and columns. They treat people very transactional way. And they actually, the problem with that is when you try to get the money from someone, you bump into a lot of cases when people don't pay and you start hating people. So the problem with your brain is that your machine learning that's inside your brain starts seeing a lot of negativity and a lot of negative cases. So that affects how you approach this entire activity, basically what kind of companies you build and what kind of what type of products you build with this. So the problem with that was that whenever someone wanted to get money from me, they treated me very transactional, and they applied the same experience that they had with me to thousands or millions of other people. However, very people are different, right? And you got to approach them differently. Right. So that's something that I saw an opportunity to, on one hand, elevate this entire customer experience or patient experience. And on the other hand, by doing so, increase the efficiency of these activities. So basically increase collections and help the creditors, or in our case, help doctors and medical providers get their money back.
Okay, cool. How do you guys, improve on that old experience, which was, treating each transaction like a number? How do you guys aim to do that differently?
You mean at Collectly?
Yeah, at Collectly.
Sure. So basically how we, what we do is, and how we do it is that we deeply integrate with the EHR systems of the medical provider. So basically in our case, it's a DrChrono. And then we compare the internal data that we get from the EHR, that we get from our own platform, with the external data that we have on patient behavior, that we collect on patient behavior, that we collect from very different statistical sources, from insurance plans. And we actually, we're building an engine that will provide the patients, each and every patient, with a very personalized experience, or more personalized experience, based on this two types of data that we have.
Okay.
So the problem with that, why it was not possible previously, that you send out a letter or a paper statement, and you're in the dark because it's not trackable, it's not traceable. You cannot know if the patient has received the bill, if they've opened the bill, if they have an intent to pay the bill, if they have any question. So in most of the cases, what they did is they either didn't receive any bill from you, or they just threw it away, or probably in the best case scenario, they called you. And that was the best case scenario. Of course, some of the people did pay, but the collection rates that we saw on paper bills in the recent years, they were horrible. There were 7 to 10%, and nobody actually. And the problem with that is that a lot of billing teams, they don't track their collection rates on patient bills. So whenever you, it's funny. So they track most of the billing teams, they track the patient collection rate as a cumulative, basically, number for all types of for all types of collections that they have. So they accumulate the number of amount of money that they get on the front desk when the patients pay as copay, then the deductibles, and then the co-insurances. But literally no billing team, like we have talked to hundreds and hundreds of billing teams, no billing team has like real great statistics and metric on what was the collection rate on the patient bill. And of course we know that in the recent years, you know, the deductibles, they're growing. So it affects a lot the bottom line of the providers these days.
Interesting. So you guys are able to track track that data where it used to be sort of a one-way conversation. You mentioned sort of sending out letters. And that was kind of one way, you know, the doctors are sending billing statements to patients. And now sort of utilizing technology we have, you're able to kind of open that up and make it more of a conversation. How do you guys do that?
Sure. So basically we transform we change the mechanic how medical providers bill their patients today. So instead of just sending out the paper bills, we start billing patients digitally. About 85% of the patients are possible to bill digitally these days. A lot of providers, they're afraid that, you know, billing digitally means billing only via email, and they don't collect enough emails in their office. So, you know, the digital patient billing is not for them. But actually, for example, we bill our patients also by texting them. And it works brilliantly, because then we actually, first of all, we make it very convenient for people to receive their bills or their notification about their bill, the new bill. Mm-hmm. Then they click on a link, they go to a payment page, and they saw they could see their notification about the balance right away on a spot. It takes just 7 seconds them to pay or to turn on the auto pay feature, where they can just literally set the, you know, if my balance is like less than $50, you know, just charge me. I don't want to be disturbed. So it's very convenient for them. And it's very convenient to manage their payment methods, to manage their bills, to ask questions. They can get an immediate support there in the chat. They can get an immediate answer to very important questions, like, you know, some patients, they, of course, don't understand how medical billing works. It's a very, I would say, sophisticated industry, and they don't know why insurance companies don't cover the entire bill. So they start, you know, like previously or like years ago, they had to call the provider and to get some sort of support. They gotta wait, you know, and that was just a bad experience. So now they can just click 2-3 buttons, get an immediate explanation, which is tailored and personalized to their health plan and to their bill. And it just works. So we use the data in a very good way to personalize the experience and make it more convenient for the patients to pay.
So these billings are going straight to people's phones, and you're saying, and it sounds like it makes collection easier. Can you tell me a little bit about like the results you guys are getting using this method?
Sure, absolutely. So a couple of results we've achieved. So the first one, previously it took about 2 to 4 weeks for the people to receive the bill, the paper bill, from the moment when the bill was sent out. With our approach, 62% of the patients view the bill the same day you send it out. So it decreases the AR quite a lot, and it boosts the patient payment velocity. That's a number that's a number one metric that we've achieved that, you know, that boosts really the collections.
The doctors can see that, like, that,
sure,
that result right away.
It's like literally, so there was a good example. One of the first DrChrono users whom we signed up with. So we've basically, you know, created the profile. We synced everything. It takes just a couple of minutes to do the initial sync, and the doctor turned on the system, and you know, the notifications they were sent out, and literally in 3 minutes the doctor received the first payment. and the doctor said, wow, like that, I could never imagine that would be possible. So wow, that works great. Yeah, so this is literally, you know, literally happening, so that people can get paid in 3 minutes since they sent out from the moment when they send out the notification.
Yeah, that's so funny. I mean, it's turning it into you know, like any other notification you get on your phone, whether it's
sure,
from Facebook, your friend messaged you on Facebook. Now you're turning that into, you know, you owe your doctor.
Absolutely. And especially for small businesses, you know, most of the practices and clinics are still small businesses. And it is especially important to kind of get the money faster.
Mm-hmm.
Since, you know, usually the small businesses are the ones who experience the cash flow gaps, and it helps to, you know, decrease the chances of the cash flow gap.
Gotcha. Well. So if you're a small or medium sized business, seriously consider using Collectly.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Cool.
Also, a couple of metrics more. So with our approach, actually, about 60% of the patients, they prefer chatting instead of calling.
Mm-hmm.
So it decreases by 60% the number of calls that the office gets. It is important because, you know, medical staff is overwhelmed. There's not enough time to, you know, to take care about the patients that are sitting there. And every minute that you save on you know, just picking up another call is really important, because you can actually use this time to treat patients. So it's really, really important as well.
Hmm.
Go ahead, sorry.
Yeah, well, I'm just thinking, like, if you are a smaller, medium-sized practice, that makes sense that, you know, you might not have a team that's dedicated strictly to billing.
Sure.
And having that response is very important. So do you guys handle kind of the messaging aspect of it?
Yeah, so basically we provide two-tier support. The first tier is like the instant answers, you know, on like frequently asked questions. And then the second tier that we provide are all the custom basic questions, which we can't answer just by getting the data and you know, utilizing the data that we have. And only about 20% of the questions we forward to the doctors or to our DrChrono customers, since it might be a clinical question which we can't answer, or some other, you know, complex, more specific question.
So 80% of those questions, instead of being
handled by
the doctors,
basically. Yeah.
Cool. Are there any other kind of metrics you'd like to share?
The patient AR gets reduced by a half about. So it's really important. And you know, the billing cycles are really, really small with our approach. So instead of like, you know, 90 days of waiting or like 180 days of waiting, it's literally a couple of weeks. So I think these are the most important benefits that Collectly brings right now to the DrChrono users.
Cool. Yeah. So you guys are a mobile company, or mobile driven and data driven. Are there any other kind of ways you guys are using maybe data science to promote your business?
We use data science basically to personalize the experience. That's the main, that's the main way. That's most important way how we apply data science in our business. And I think this is pretty it. So we definitely have like some algorithms. I don't want to say it's an AI because it's just like a buzzword. But data science and machine learning, yes, we do.
Interesting. And I'd like to talk a little bit about growth, maybe growth of your business or growth in healthcare and technology.
Sure.
Are there any kind of technologies you're excited for that are growing and kind of might provide your business with some new tools or toolboxes in the future?
I think that I see a great potential how the AR and VR might be applied in healthcare. I'm really, really personally, I'm really excited about it. I think that with the new technologies, we can actually really save more people, save more lives. And I'm just, I'm so happy for all the founders who working very, very hard to make it happen. So I think it's great. In regards to our business, definitely the machine learning and, the entire data science approaches that become available in the last couple of years, they kind of unlocked this opportunity to improve the patient experience. And patient experience is definitely one of the most important aspects of the healthcare that is, it's great that people started to care about it more and more in the last couple of years. I think that by providing a better care, by providing the better experience, you can actually grow your business as well. So it's important.
Yeah, patient care and outcome based health is definitely where things are headed, and it sounds like you guys are fitting right in, especially with those kind of new age trends towards using the mobile technologies we have and making the most out of kind of the tools that are available.
That's exactly right. Yeah.
Cool. All right, Levon, thanks for joining me. How about we plug some stuff? Where can people find you? How can people get in touch?
Absolutely. You can find me anywhere, anywhere you like in LinkedIn. I'm definitely a company website, which is www.collectly.co. We are getting a couple of new releases soon with, and upgrades of the software to make the experience even more, even better. I think you can use my email, which is levon@collectly.co as well. And I'm pretty open to new conversations, and I'm looking forward to continue helping providers get their money.
Thanks for joining me, and let's get that money.